why not? I mean, we got 5,000 volts available.
Good picture of the future.
Yeah.
The future is here.
Yeah, I know.
I grew up in Southern California. My dad, every once in a while, went home with a
the project, whether it was a car or a little boat or something, he was always in the garage. So it was always creative kind of flow in that house that just got me excited. And it's like things happen either in the music room or in the garage. That's what the two places that were exciting to me. Growing up in California, especially Southern California, people were interested in going fast, building hot rods, building the next thing, whether it's, you know, build something to take to the salt flats. For me, I was interested in going fast. And through the art world, a few artists that ended up all belonging to the same art club. Why this club? And I got to know one of the guys, Dennis Vale, who he's designed tattoos, and he brought me to one of the shows where he was working with other guys, and he sponsored me in the club. So I was hanging out with these artists that were the first spectacular, Tiz and Juan Franco, Jack Moody, a lot of guys either in the tattoo world, custom culture world, were pretty well respected. For me, my family history, my dad left when I was 14, my mom passed away when I was 16, so my family kind of disintegrated. But ever since, I've kind of been looking for belonging, for a sense of family. So joining a car club, joining a band, obviously creating my own family. And the car club did that for me. The way cars are created in music, pretty similar to that. A chapter that's kind of closing to me as far as being able to create and build some of the coolest cars that I have ever done that long ago. We've gone after our ultimates, like the Zephyr, the 36 Ford, and created new things out of it. There's Skyline. I mean, those are cars that are iconic, short, and we put our own. These are joking, and they are drivable, but they're beautiful. These cars are my big hand. I've had them sitting here in the garage in Northern California. I want more people to see them. Simple as that. I've had my life. I've got my life around them. So I like the Petersen Museum also. It's the pinnacle of the collection, I would say, of cars. To be a part of that is an honor. And to be able to put these on display, it's going to inspire some young kids and say, hey, that's really cool. I can do that. You know, that's what I would love to see. At one point, we were all youth, and you never know where you're going to get your inspiration. You know, as for me, watching my dad disappear into the garage, that was an inspiration. Is he doing in there? What's going on? Or, you know, listen to a song. How did they create that? You know, or just having a, sitting in the corner of the house, you could have to start moving around, and all of a sudden, you got a passion and a love and a purpose. So being a part of the Petersen makes complete sense, and I'm super honored to be here that day.
Championship took a lot of heat for coming to Indy. You know, he kind of broke rank, and he was the first guy that came to Indy. We all thought it would probably be Roger Penske.
We were in the kart and the IRL at the same time in 2000. Penske had to do the kart race in Nazareth on Saturday. I think one of them, too.